Okay, before we can put kinematics to our machine, first let us segregate all these components into appropriate containers within this product assembly. By containers, I mean we need to group which components are considered as fixed component and which components are considered as x-axis movement, y-axis movement, z-axis movement, etc. So to do that, I'm going to insert some additional components here. You can do this by two methods. One is right-clicking on the main product and then go to the components and insert new component. Or another method is go to insert and then choose new component and select the main product. So either method, okay. I'm preferring the right click method here. So I'm going to delete this first. Okay, right click on the main product components and I'm going to insert a new component. Okay, this is the new component that I inserted. So I'm going to rename it. How I get this properties dialog box? Okay, you can right click on the product and go to properties, or you can use this shortcut key here, alternate enter. So I mostly prefer the shortcut key instead of the keyboard. So alternate enter brings out the properties window. So now I can rename this product as a, let's say, a fixed component, not fixed component. Maybe some other update name, but I cannot think of any right now. Fixed component, and then this is fixed component one. Simply okay. So now what we're going to do is we are going to drag and drop fixed component into this container. The number one and foremost is going to drag this enclosure and put it inside the fixed component. So this is my fixed component. I have enclosure now. What else? Okay, base casting here. I'm going to drag it and drop it into the fixed component as well. Just to make things clear, I'm going to hide this fixed component just to remind me which component has been inserted into the fixed component and which are not. So X header should be moving, so it's not going to be fixed. This is tool changer. We are not going to simulate the tool change movement, so I'm going to put it into the fixed component. Y axis should be moving. Okay, this coolant tank should be fixed. Then Z axis should be moving. Okay, so this is fixed. B axis should be rotating later. This is okay. I think this one, this coolant assembly should be moving together with this Z axis spindle head. It cannot be fixed because otherwise it's going to be hanging up in the air during our machining simulation later. So this also should be moving. So these are all the fixed components. Okay, I'm going to show it again. And then just as it names, I'm going to fix this. Okay, you can fix our component by two methods. One is using the constraint toolbar. Where is my constraint toolbar? Somewhere in this right toolbar here. You can pull out any toolbar from this toolbar, right toolbar or bottom toolbar. Either toolbars, you can drag and drop the toolbar into the viewing portion of CATIA. By drag and drop, or another method is just double clicking. You see this small horizontal line there, just double click on that line and the toolbar will get dragged out from the place automatically. So you can drag out all the toolbar until you can see this constraints toolbar here and drag it to the top toolbar placement. So this is the constraint. So you can fix any component by using this constraint toolbar. This is the fix icon. Click on the anchor icon there to fix this fixed component. So once you introduce a constraint, sorry, you can see this constraints folder appear in the product stream. So this is component that going to be fixed in our assembly. So just put it as it is there. We fix all the fixed component. Okay, now we are going to create another container. Okay, create a new component. And similarly, just rename it. Oops, sorry. Just going to rename it for X motion to imply any components that's supposed to be moving in X direction should be within this container. So this is our X motion container. So go back to our product structure tree. Okay. Another thing is, if your product structure tree is too small for you to read, you can always zoom the product structure as well. To zoom it, you can click first you can click on the white branch on the product structure. You see this vertical branch and the horizontal branches. Click on either branch. So once you click on that branch, your 3D model get grayed out. So now you can zoom in using this icon here to zoom in your product structure or to zoom out. Okay, that is one method. Another method is, instead of clicking on the branch on the branches, you can use a shortcut key, a combination of shift and F3. So it produces the same effect. So now you can zoom in. And once you are comfortable with the product structure tree representation, you can shift F3 again to make the 3D model active. Okay, so now when you click on this button, instead of the product structure tree get zoom in or zoom out, you can use it on your 3D model instead. Okay, now moving on. So what components should be included into this X motion container? So firstly is this X axis saddle, obviously. So I'm going to drag this and drop it inside this container. What else? Do we have this? No. No. This should be moving inside this. This is okay. That's it. Only one component inside this X motion container. So I'm going to create another container for Y axis motion. Okay, my computer. Okay, insert a new component and then name it as Y motion. You see, most of the time, our processes are a repetition of same technique. So, what components should be moving in Y motion? Okay, obviously this one. Okay, this is Z axis, so we're going to create another container for that. Okay, rename it Z motion. Okay, and bring Z motion or Z axis spindle into this container, and as mentioned, the coolant turret or P-cool here should also go inside this Z motion container, so they will be moving together. Okay, for this one, you can create a container as well, or you can remain it as it is. Okay, for me, I prefer to move on the moving parts into its own component, own container. So this should be in B motion. Okay, just drag it and drop it into the container. The last one is C motion. Alright, so that's it. Now we have arranged our product.